Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Box Nation. So, as you can see, as some things have changed, the game was updated and I decided to revisit it. What did change? So, first of all, to play you must be logged into Steam Client. That is important because in episode 0, the one I couldn't start the game, that was the reason why. You need to be logged into Steam in order to do it. And another big thing changed. We have a rating now. So if you press rating, we can actually see where our place is. We can actually see here, and I'm placed 3, which means there are only 4 people currently playing this game. Okay, that is not a good sign. But anyway, I'm now placed 3, so there's now a reason to actually play. You compete against other people. That's very good. Okay, so let's see what other things are changed. First of all, it's very, very smooth. You can see it's still the same computer and it's incredibly smooth. So the graphic was fixed. Another thing is we have shortcuts, big shortcuts. So I just press 1. No, I just select this and press 1. And now it's built, like I suggested in the last episode, I think. It's perfect. So everything can be now done with shortcuts. That is very, very big. Now, the only complaint I have is sometimes the click doesn't work. I don't know what's going on here. Sometimes that's not what I wanted. That was not what I wanted to do. Okay, so ignore my idiocy there. Why can't I select this? Okay, so I think I ruined something there. So yeah, what's our goal for today? Our goal for today is to explore what has changed and what the new challenges are. And I think there are a couple of challenges. So my goal right now is to build an empire that can survive. Because last time I think we built something that might survive, but the game has changed. Come on, do that. The game changed now, and it has become much more difficult, I think, to do what I did last time. The enemies are spawning, I think, faster, or maybe I was just lucky last time. Anyway, I tried a test run of this game, and I was defeated, like, instantly. So the challenge is definitely there. It's no longer that easy. Or again, maybe I was just really lucky last time. So let's see, what do we do? We should collect that block, that boxing block, because it's about to be destroyed. They have a self-destruction mechanism. So the short keys are amazing. I love the short keys. They're really, really great. Only downside is sometimes they don't work. Now, that's a big downside. What I mean by don't work, sometimes I need to click multiple times or press multiple times in order, I'm pressing and nothing happens. That is bad. Now, you will be a miner. Again, it's the same principle. He's too stupid. So he can't pass through some blocks. That's a shame. Now, please go. And while we are at it, in order to speed up things, we can, how do we do that? We will build here a factory. Or how it's called, refinery. Whatever that is, that's a refinery now. And I would like to shed some light onto the whole situation. Here, give light. Amazing. Perfect. Create more blocks. And detect the dimension breakthrough. Now we should deal with that as fast as possible because it might destroy us. I will take a risk here and I won't deal with that immediately. So ignore what I just said. Let's give it some time. He will build to us in a moment. And we have more than enough boxing blocks. Actually, we don't have more than enough boxing blocks. We have only 16. That is definitely not enough. So if that guy is fast, he will overwhelm us. But he's usually not very smart. He will just do something stupid instead. So please move here and we will turn you into a miner. Yeah, definitely. And please give me another block. You will become a refinery in a couple of moments, like right now. Please become a refinery. And now I would like to shed some light on that situation. And now we have 8 boxing blocks. Now we have a lot of going on. What is this miner doing? He finished mining that. Now I'm a bit scared. I think I might run out of blocks here. Let's fix that here. Let's build a soldier. We desperately need a soldier right now. We will give him defense here and we will make him a soldier. Now, one soldier is usually not enough in this game. You usually need a couple of them. So let's do that. And I would like to do something amazing. I would like to build a pyramid. I tried to doing that off screen and it was not that easy. But yeah, I'm gonna try to do it anyway. I think that would be an amazing place for a pyramid. Actually, how do we do that? Let's sell. Not what I wanted to do. Anyway, let's now, how do we do that? No, you, I want to start building my amazing pyramid here, like that. Maybe I should build another soldier just to be sure. Okay, so now we have an adequate protection, and we are building the foundation of our amazing pyramid. Who are you? Oh, he's near us, but I don't think he's... What is the miner doing here? Oh, we mined everything out. So there's no reason for miners to be there anymore. Okay, but we will defeat him in a moment, and that will provide us with a big amount of boxing blocks. So I think the best strategy here is just defeat enemies mine at the start of the game to just build your army, and after you've done that, there's no really any point in mining anymore because you can just defeat the enemies. What are you doing? Oh yeah, I think they're destroying. Oh, please survive that. We are so close to defeating him. Come on. What is the miner doing? I don't get it. The miner does something very stupid here. What is the miner doing? Okay, that made boom and everything's dead. Okay, and we have so much boxing blocks. That's more than enough to build our pyramid and to build another army. And I'm very, very happy with that. Now, the only complaint I have is that I can't command the soldiers. So the soldiers are very stupid and they will suicide. And suicide is obviously bad for us. But that's not that bad. Okay. So what am I doing here? I am trying to build a pyramid and it takes much more resources than I had anticipated, actually. And for some reason, this game invites you to press really hard on the keyboard because sometimes it does nothing when you press the key. So maybe if I press slowly and take my time, maybe it will be better. Okay, he's coming. I should probably prepare. How many soldiers do we need? I think 2 soldiers are more than enough. In fact, I don't think so. Let's just create 3 soldiers just in case. That's just to be on the sure side of things, because if you fail here and another one is being created. In fact, I think we need a plaza. Because I'm starting to getting lost here. I'm getting lost in this whole shebang. Let's now the soldiers have a room to move and I can concentrate on building my blocks. Now, again, our pyramid. That doesn't look like a pyramid yet. In fact, that looks like just like some sort of plaza. But in a moment, something amazing will be built on this foundation. Just give me some time. I will be done in a moment. I hope so, at least. I hope I won't be killed while doing that. I probably should get rid of the miners. They are no longer necessary. And now we are building. Now our pyramid is becoming a pyramid. That is where it starts. That is where it gets exciting. Now, why are we building a pyramid, you know? What is the point of it? Well, it is very important because it will provide us with morale. In fact, it will provide us with something to do while the soldiers do their nonsense there. And you don't want to get bored in this. It's a sandbox game, so what do you do? You build stuff, you know? It's like sitting in a sandbox and what do we build in a sandbox? I don't know. I don't think I ever played in a sandbox, actually. Well, it was so long ago, I completely forgot. So I think in a sandbox, you usually build towers or something, or buildings, I don't even know. Maybe you choose sand in each other's faces, that is what children usually do. Anyway, here, we have built a pyramid, it's finished. No, it's not finished. We need to put something on top. What do we put on top? Light, of course. Now it's finished. And to make it really beautiful, I will turn it into a factory. Now, that is a pyramid we can be proud of. That is the sign of our glory, of our glorious empire. This will serve as an amazing, it's an amazing rallying point for I don't even know, for something. Now, we lost all our soldiers there. That's unfortunate. Let's create new ones. And while we had it, I don't even care about that. Somebody broke into our dimension. Some new dungeon hearts have spawned. Like, I even care. Now, 2 soldiers should be enough to defend the most basic enemy. So what is that? Why did I build that? What is even that? That is something very stupid. Let's just remove that. I did not want to do that. Oh, damn it. Can I somehow break out of this menu? I accidentally put us into a menu and now we are stuck in it. Don't exit. Don't do that. Oh, now there's nothing we can do. Can we move him here? And can we turn him into a soldier again? Great. We just lost boxing blocks there for no apparent reason. Now, to make us more flexible, I would suggest increasing this plaza, because I think that is important. Otherwise, you can get confused with things that are going on, and I think sometimes your soldiers are not moving through blocks, and it can confuse everyone around. Don't do that. So, I think in a few moments we will have a solid foundation for an empire again. That, and are we finished yet? I'm not sure. I think we need another, we need another area. Just in case. Just in case something bad happens, I want here to have there some sort of space so that the soldiers can actually move. Okay, are we done yet? I think we are nearly done. Yeah, that is the last thing that is... No, not the last one. We still need to put that there. Okay, so we did it. Now, what is going on? I think we have a guest. We should prepare for our guest, because guests deserve a nice welcome. Let's provide them with an amazing welcome. Let's provide them with a welcome party, in fact. With a welcome party of death. Now, more soldiers and even more soldiers. Now, that should be more than enough. Oh, look at that. Two. How will that work out? Oh, that is so interesting. If we defeat the right one, which blocks will actually be gone? You know, that looks incredibly scary. I should deal with that immediately. I think something very bad will happen. Oh, it's too late. How do I do that? So I have an idea. I will create a reservation army. So you will become a soldier in preparation. So how does a reservation army work? It works like this. You put blocks in a place, and then you provide them with defense. That way, you can easily convert them into... Oh, what these idiots. Look at them. I have no words for that. Anyway, while we're in the menu, the game has paused. So, what did I just do? Please don't. So we have created four soldiers of our reserve army. Let's create even more. Let's create more. So what do I mean again by reserve army? We just equip them with a skill of protection. And that will allow us to very quickly generate strong soldiers. Will you be able to deal with him? I think you will. What are you doing? Do you see that dude there? I know what you... Oh no. Oh no, we lost our soldiers. Anyway, this dude is trying to get to the dungeon hut. But he can't because... Yeah, because he's stupid. He should go the other way around. Well, nothing we can do about that. That's... I think we should create pathways. Because if we create here finished pathways, the enemy will build less. I don't know if that makes sense. So what I'm trying to say here is, it takes a long time for the enemy to build this passageway. But if we build it for him, he will approach us more faster. And the faster he can approach us, the faster he can die. So it's actually... Oh, do you see that? This idiot. I can't believe it. Okay, please. Can we actually teleport him? Sometimes this game is a bit weird. So okay, we teleported him. Now, you will be turned into a soldier. So we are releasing our army. Here, I will release, in fact, as much as possible because I'm a bit scared right now. Yeah, so the idea of the reservation army, I really like that. It creates an amazing line of defense. And it's immediately down to our dungeon heart. Why I'm there? What did just happen? I'm not sure. Why can't I see him? What? I think something died, right? That was not what I intended to do. I think I just killed something. That was mine. Anyway, here. Now it's repaired again. What's going on? Yeah, he died, and we received a huge amount of boxing blocks. So okay, and that is my new strategy. We just built... no. We just built... come on, what are you doing? This is so stupid. Anyway, we built our reservation army near the heart. And then Yeah, we're just waiting. We are sitting in waiting and waiting. We're waiting for something to kill us. I mean, something to attack us. What's going on? Yeah, I need to first press start and press start. My fingers hurting because I'm constantly pressing because it's like I need to press two times for it to actually do something. Please, one last time. You move there. Wow, my fingers are actually hurting. That should not happen. Are we finished? No, we're not finished. You are a you need protection. Now, perfectly. That's it. That is our empire, that is how it looks. In my opinion, that can defeat anything. Nothing that the game can show at us can compete with that. If you see that more enemies appear, well, you build bigger reservation army. But that's basically it. That is That is Box Nation in its current state. I think this strategy will basically win the game. Win you the game. And I could just sit here and I could farm. And I think it will reach us. It will go into the high score. Now, I'm not sure how the high score works. I assume it is the amount of boxiums that we have. So we would just need to wait before that amazing smart race here. That smart AI actually kills himself by connecting to us, and then we get his blocks, and his blocks will be also ours. And do that for maybe half an hour, and eventually you will reach the high score. Now, I don't think I will do that, because that's kind of a waste of time. But yeah, that is how it is right now. I'm not sure if these green blocks can be auto-generated, if they just can spawn in front of us. I'm not sure about that. I think they can. I think I witnessed something like that before. But there must be some sort of algorithm that decides who spawns where. Now I would like... See, I just pressed it and nothing happened. I don't know why there's this bug. So again, I press. And now it's for selected. Now, one. Press. One. Because I would like to extend the street. Because the faster the enemy can reach us, the faster we can deal with him. Please. It's ignoring my keys. Come on, don't ignore my keys. One. Press again. Press. Now. One. Click. Now it worked. Okay. So I'm just trying to speed up the demise of that dude. Whatever. Here. Why does this have a heart? That is interesting. So some blocks, the blocks have heart. Heart. So if I put something in its way, the soldiers would probably destroy the block. Anyway, what I find interesting is the fact that I think there's some sort of pattern to how the enemies are building their streets. Because look, if that guy to the left will start building this street, then there's definitely a pattern. Because here's my heart. So he's trying to build... he's not smart enough to build diagonally. You know what? I'm in trouble, actually. I should build my soldiers. What am I doing here? I should release my reservation army. That was very stupid. So yeah. Come on, please. Yeah, that should be more than enough to deal with them. Now I would like to have some sort of... I don't know, it would be interesting to have a macro that does it. But anyway, he's dead. He's dead, and I can even create more soldiers now. There's nothing that can stop us at this point. Unless, of course, a lot of them spawn simultaneously. That would be an issue. And I think something's happening. Something is bad is happening. Are they being stupid again? I think they're being stupid again. We see that they are they're trying to get across, but they can't because they're stupid. I don't like this pathfinding mechanic. Why are they so stupid? Come on, pathfinding. Oh, look at that. Could you please, for the love of God. I think I need another strategy. I think I should create defensive structures or something. Maybe a pathway that the enemy must cross in order to get to me. Maybe that would make it much easier. So yeah, I think my strategy that I thought to be ideal is not ideal at all. I think it's still very lacking. Now, another soldier, please, just in case. Have we done here? Oh, look at them, they're so stupid. What are they doing? What are they literally doing? Do we need a miner? What's going on? Come on. Oh, the soldiers are wasting their time by trying to go there, but they can't go there. This is so ridiculous. And this... Okay, so that was what's happening. These three soldiers were trying to get past these blocks to reach this guy, but there's no way for them to reach him, so why even try? But because these two blocks were in the way, they couldn't, so well. And what is he doing now? I'm confused. He's trying to get something. Can I destroy that? No, I can't. So I don't know what just happened. I don't understand this. But it's gone now anyway. And with it, our whole army was defeated. So I should probably... Yeah, I should probably fill that up. With new soldiers. Not even reservation soldiers, just real soldiers. And for some reason, we are not advancing. Our Boxium... The amount of Boxium blocks we have at our disposal is still fairly low. Now, why is that? I think we are not being very effective. We are wasting much more Boxium blocks. Come on, guys, look at what they're doing. Why are they on the wrong place? So, okay, we need to deal with him. As long as he's there, the soldiers will try to attack him, and he will be in a bad place. So let's deal with him. Let's just do it. In fact, let's not do that. Because the soldiers, the enemy will build this pathway. So we might as well help him here, come on. Or maybe... What are you doing? We are dying! What the hell? Look at that! Please, do something. What's going on? Are we actually dying? I would not like to die right now if I could avoid it. To be completely honest with you. Who do we deal with first? So he will be there in a moment. I could just speed that up, in fact. Just kill him as fast as you can. And why are this? Okay, these soldiers, they will hopefully defeat that guy on the bottom, and we will be able to concentrate on the one on the top. I don't like that. You see that soldier, he's just wasting our time here. That is not a good soldier. Now please finish him. Put him out of his misery, because I don't like these two blocks here. They're troubling me. Okay, boom, it's gone. It's gone, and now, and of course, another one immediately appears. So I think there must be a rule or something. I think we have always two, at least two guys. So if I'm correct in my assumption, he will build this pathway, exactly this one. That seems to be the AI mechanic. Come on, don't do that. So we need to deal, okay. Can you, okay, he did it for us. Anyway, let's... do we have even enough soldiers to defend ourselves? I'm not sure if we have. So let's create even more. And that should provide us with enough protection. Yeah, and what happens now? Can we create another one? Maybe don't create too much. Oh, come on, I don't understand. Why are they so stupid? Why can't they? What is he doing? Why is he even there? So... You see, I need to babysit him. I need to make sure that this thing is built. Otherwise, they will just stay there and do nothing. And I think my theory was in fact wrong. You see, they're building another passageway. So there's no logic behind how they build it. Well, that's unfortunate. But anyway, come on, build the last block. We can defeat him. And what's going on now? I'm a bit scared. Be honest, because they will all die right now. Okay, if one has survived, one soldier has survived this massacre, and we need as much soldiers as we can. We have 300 Boxium blocks. He will die in a moment, by the way. Oh wow, so many soldiers died. That is so sad. Can you turn the miner actually into a soldier? Yeah, we can. That's useful. And another soldier, and I just want to survive this. Oh, look at them enemies! That is so scary. Okay, I think this is our end. Can I somehow fix this situation? Somehow? Please? I wonder, how is it balanced? Does it get progressively harder the more you play? Because it seems that way. I think there's some sort of number that's running up in the background. And what's going on? Look at that. I'm literally shooting things at it. I'm throwing my soldiers at him and he just takes it on his chin. He doesn't even care. That is a very, very powerful army that he has there. And I'm still a bit. I dislike the fact that this soldier is an absolute idiot and that he's trying to go that way. But I think, oh no, look at that. They passed. Come on, stop doing that. Become a soldier, please. What? What is going on here? I think we glitched the enemy. Soldier, please do something amazing. Oh, it makes boom, but it doesn't really, I don't see what's going on. Okay, so it's a lot of button mashing right now, and I think we're dead. So the challenge level is certainly there. That is good. But I don't really understand why. Why are we dying? What is really killing us? Why is the enemy so buffed? What's the point behind it? I mean, how does it logically work? Did somebody just fell through the floor? It looks like that. Okay, look at that, how much stuff she's generating, and there's another one behind. Okay, so that is probably our end. I don't think we can do that. We can't proceed any further. And yeah, that looks like our demise. I can't place them faster. Maybe if I should use the shortcuts more efficiently, maybe I should do that. So 4, 2, 5, then again here. 1, 4, 2, 5. And look at that. What is this box doing there? Maybe I should create an alternative way here. And let them actually work here. Now that soldier, he's getting on my nerves. Could you please move finally here? I will provide a passageway just for you, for the very stupidest of the stupidest. Anyway, here. You have the passageway now. It's done. Now he can finally go. Now he actually goes. And it was worthless. But do you see that? He survived, and that is amazing. If you're lucky, he will destroy that one. Now, we got Boxium back for it, but we are still in the negative. We are still in the reds. We lost more Boxium than we gained from that. Yeah. Now we are making progress, but that is still not enough. And yeah, we will need to... We are losing a lot of Boxium blocks, because now we need to create another army. Okay, so the game is really challenging, in fact. I don't know what an optimal strategy would be here. The reserve army strategy is not that useful in the late game, I think. In the late game, you just need all the soldiers you can basically get. Wow. So I don't know how to deal with that. Exactly. We should build protection, actually. I'm not sure if that makes any sense for the enemy. I don't even know. Does it make any sense if you build something like this? Like a pathway that is not straight, so the enemy... But I don't know his strategies. I don't know how exactly the enemy will build. So I thought about creating some sort of zigzag pattern. But will that really benefit us? I don't know. So okay, please, go. I don't want to see you there anymore here. Just go. Or maybe, I changed my mind, maybe we should keep him there. Because you know, as long as he is staying there, he is distracting the enemy. And the enemy is stupid. But anyway guys, that was Box Nation, that is the current state of the update, the current state of the progress. I really love the fact that we have finally shortcuts. It's very, very important. It makes such a big change, I think. Just need to get used to them, and it's such an amazing speed up. Even if I'm not always using them, come on. 5. Okay, so that is how it is right now, and I think maybe we did make it into the high score, I'm not sure. I will check out later. Oh, you made a big mistake, buddy. That was a very big mistake. Now, I would like to not lose soldiers here. So can you please build some blocks around that? Because if he inevitably dies, I don't want to lose all my soldiers. Yeah, and we survived. Not a single soldier was lost there. That is amazing. And I think I moved in the high score up. Anyway, guys, that's it. It just saved, so I can stop here. And if you enjoyed press the like button, the game is on Steam right now. I think it's a sale. And the developer even, I think the developer posted a few Steam keys on my last video, video on episode 3, if I remember correctly. So if they're still there, you can grab them for free. That is a very good thing, because why not, you know? Anyway, and if you enjoyed it, press the like button. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.